7 Go Wild, the show where an S-Clubber goes into the wild of a faraway country to search for an endangered animal. This week we see what happened on my adventure when I went looking for a Siberian tiger.
Name?
Rachel.
Height?
1.6 metres.
Likes?
Sleeping in the day.
Hobbies?
Walking, swimming, running.
Special skills?
I can jump 1 metre in the air.
Population?
1 of 7.
Name?
Siberian tiger.
Length?
3.8 metres.
Likes?
Going out at night.
Hobbies?
Walking, swimming, running.
Special skills?
Can leap 10 metres.
Population?
One of 500 left in the wild. I'll be travelling all the way to the far east of Russia, and I'll be accompanied by fellow S-Clubber, Paul.
Hi.
We've just arrived in Moscow. We're on our way to look for the Siberian tiger.
Oh.
We're going to be travelling to a place called Vladivostok, which is in the far east of Russia. We've decided to stop off in Moscow for a day, so we thought we'd check out the city.
Oh, it's really amazing.
Oh, look, there's a bloke.
Are these sort
of Russian gold? Normally they're women. Maybe
like that.
Sort of like branch out into the market. Ah, oh look, there's another bloke. Yeltsin.
Yeltsin.
Is that Yeltsin? And I wonder who's inside Yeltsin. Look.
Gorbachev.
Gorbachev.
Stalin.
Stalin.
Lenin.
Lenin.
All the leaders.
That'll look cornbread.
Yeah.
Put it on. Oh, very nice.
I think my head's far too big.
Well, we better go, Paul, because we're going to be late for the flight.
Yeah, cool.
Got your tickets?
Yeah, yeah. Wait a second, I did have it in here.
Paul, please tell me you haven't lost it.
Oh, God. It was in my pocket. I was certain
Paul,
it was in my pocket.
You're going to miss the plane.
Oh, I'll catch up with you.
Yeah, you meet me out there.
Yeah, 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 I will.
Paul, all right.
I'm sorry, I'm just...
Well, I've got to go, I've got to go. All right, see you later, yeah?
Okay, take care.
See ya. Vladivostok at last.
Although Paul's travelled all over the world with S Club 7, there's one thing that he's no good at, and that's directions. I hope he'll be okay. Whenever I'm away, I always bring things with me to remind me of home, so the first thing I bought is this little devil. I think it's really cute, and I got it from a fan in Asia. And it squeaks. I've also bought letters that I got from fans. It's a nice thing to be able to sort of reply to them, so when I've got a bit of free time, that's what I do.
Excuse me. Could you tell me the way to Vladivostok? No? No? Okay. Excuse me, could you tell me the way to Vladivostok? No?
No.
No? No? But she spoke English.
Always bring a picture of the band with me because, well, I'm not with them now, so I really miss them, so I've got to bring that to remind me of them. Since I'm looking for the tiger, I thought I'd bring my own little fluffy one with me. Hope it brings me luck in finding the real thing.
Do you know the way to Vladivostok? No? The Siberian tiger? Rawr.
Vladivostok?
Yeah, yeah.
Siberia,
yeah? Yeah, Siberia, yeah, that's right.
Вам надо туда ехать.
That way?
Да.
Is that for the tiger as well? Oh, is that way?
Нет, нет, туда нужно ехать, я вам правильно говорю.
Okay. Okay, well, I'll go this way, because you said this way. Okay, thank you. Thanks. Take care.
We've come down to a market because in a couple of days we're going to a reserve and I need some wellies because they're going to be really wet. There's been a typhoon here apparently, so follow me and I'm going to try and find some. It's not really my style of clothes, but we might have some luck, you never know. Where am I going to find wellies? I don't know. Oh, look, this reminds me of Paul. Cheeky monkey. Speaking of Paul, I hope he gets here soon. I'm a bit lonely without him.
Excuse me, mate. Is Vladivostok that way? Is that way?
I've got to get off. I'm in completely the wrong place.
I need to go in the other direction. I need to get to Vladivostok. Where's the captain of this ship?
Oh, this is cute. Oh, that's sweet. I like that. Seeing as we're going into the wild, I've got to have my little tiger bag to fit all my little bits in. Oh. What do you think? Excellent. Got the wellies for me and Paul. I hope he appreciates all the hard work that went into this. Now we can really get wet and muddy in style.
Vladivostok! 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 I need a ride to Vladivostok. Are you going to Vladivostok? I need to see the tiger. Rawr!
Whilst I'm waiting for Paul, I decided to visit the Arseniev Museum in Vladivostok to learn more about the Siberian tiger.
Just got to the museum in Vladivostok, and this is the actual first time I've seen a Siberian tiger. This is a real tiger, and I just am overwhelmed at how huge it is. Its paw is the size of my head, probably bigger. It's just unbelievable. It's just huge. Did you know that there are only 500 of these cats left in the world? It's unbelievable how huge they are. It's the 10th longest animal in the whole world. I can't actually believe that I might be coming this close to one of them. Well, hopefully not this close. But I'm really excited to see a real one now. Bit scared, though.
Where has Paul got to? I know he's out there somewhere.
I'm so glad I found you.
Where have you been?
Well, I've been hitchhiking, trying to get on a boat and a plane. I've had an absolute nightmare. How about you? What have you been doing?
Oh, just out and about in the town. It's a great city, yeah, it's really cool. But come, we've got to go and pack. We've got to go see the tiger tomorrow.
Already? But I've only just got here.
Yeah, we've got to go see the tiger.
Can't you take me around the city first? I wouldn't mind, you know. Please?
Oh, all right, I'll show you around.
The coastal city of Vladivostok is located in the extreme east of Russia, squeezed between China and Korea. As well as being a naval port overlooking the Sea of Japan, it is also one of Russia's more attractive cities.
Did you know that a tiger can eat 50 kilograms of meat in one sitting?
Wow, that's one big burger.
Yeah, and apparently they like to eat rotting meat.
Maybe I'll save this for them.
But what people don't realise is that 90% of the time, a tiger fails to catch its prey.
Really?
Yeah, a bit like you with women.
Yeah, yeah. Why is that?
It's because tigers don't have much endurance. So if their first initial burst of speed fails, they just give up.
No, I meant me with women.
Oh, right. It could be your haircut. Or it could even be your clothes, or maybe your shoes.
This is going to be a long trip.
Oh, look at this!
Huh?
How cool!
Oh, yeah!
Yeah, okay, shall we? Now we've heard your music, I think we're going to play you some of ours.
Today, which is a 2-hour journey on the train, we're going to a reserve to try and find the tiger. Are you going to be scared when we get there?
Maybe. I mean, it depends how we're looking at them. It depends if we're in a vehicle or whether we're... I don't know. I don't know how we're going to be,
Well, I hope we're not on foot next to them.
I'm not walking on foot next to the tigers, no. Oh, hello, Mr. Tiger. Do you want some breakfast? No. Right, so we're here, Rach.
Excellent.
I think... Yeah?
This way?
Yeah. Oh, hi, Rachel.
Hello.
Great, you've arrived. Did you have a good trip?
Yeah, really nice, thank you.
Fantastic.
How are you?
Great. Welcome to Ussuriskia Reserve.
Thank you.
Right, we've got lots of exciting things for you to go and see and do.
Brilliant.
So come on, let's not waste any time.
How many tigers are here?
Well, what we've got to look for is what the tiger leaves behind when it moves, and that's a footprint. And on this sandy bank, if you look really carefully, you can just about make out a paw print.
Oh, yeah. So is this a regular track for a tiger, then? This is like... We're on his territory, basically.
Definitely, yeah. What we've just walked through is literally a trail that a tiger uses. And it's come down to the river, maybe to drink, or it's maybe, you know, walked across.
So can you tell from this paw print whether it's a male or a female?
Well, yes, you can, but unfortunately this is pretty washed out, so it's difficult. But what you've got to imagine is in the winter time, when the tiger leaves its footprint in the snow, you can see a really strong definition of the footprint. And if you measure the footprint, and it's a really big one, so like 10 or 11 centimetres wide, then you know you've got a male, because the females are smaller.
It is a huge footprint, isn't it?
Well, I was going to just say, actually, it probably is a male. I have to say, it is a big print.
So, Paul, tell me, what distinguishes a Siberian tiger from other tigers?
Not a lot, really, other than the fact that the Siberian tiger is the biggest tiger in the world. And the reason for that is that it lives in the coldest climate, and so it has to have a really thick, big fur.
So what does the Siberian tiger eat?
The Siberian tiger lives in the forest, so it hunts animals that live in forests, and that's mainly deer and also wild pigs and boar.
Just out of interest, they don't eat humans on a day-to-day basis.
It's extremely rare. There's tigers around us, which makes us feel pretty special,
But at the moment, you know, they're quite shy animals, they're quite secretive, so they won't come and disturb us now.
So what is being done by the WWF to help in the falling numbers?
One of the most important things now is to actually protect the tiger's habitat, and that means that we want to see a creation or a network of protected areas where the tiger lives. And one of the things that we have tried to do successfully is to run anti-poaching brigades. And what they do is they actually work in the tiger reserves and they try and stop the poachers killing the tiger.
Right, well, while Rachel's out and about, my mission is to find some accommodation. As you can see, it looks a bit dodgy around here. I mean, that isn't exactly the best kind of coziest place I've seen in a while. But I'll go and see what else there is. Well, this very kind family say that I can stay with them if I milk their goat. Hiya. I'm much better on the left than the right.
I've never ever milked a goat before. I've never milked anything.
Well, I finished milking the goat and I thought I did pretty well, but apparently half an inch of milk just isn't enough, so we're not allowed to stay. Never mind. Thank you.
So Rachel, sadly this is what it's all about. This is a tiger that's been shot. If you look really carefully, you can actually see, if you look here, see some bullet holes.
I can't believe it.
And it's really sad, isn't it, to see such a magnificent creature now in this state.
Would you say that a tiger is killed every day?
Well, it's been estimated throughout the tiger's whole range that there is a tiger being lost every day. The anti-poaching brigades, they work in different ways, but one of the things they do is they sometimes go out in this tank. If you have a look, this is what we're going to go out in today. And if we're, you know, really lucky, you know, and you keep your eyes peeled, we may even see a tiger.
We're just running!
This anti-poaching brigade's job is to protect the tiger. They cover an area of over 165,000 square kilometres and search the forest looking for poachers. With this army tank, they can practically go anywhere. The brigade also prevents illegal logging of the forest, which destroys the animal's habitat. So with their help, the Siberian tiger has a much better chance of surviving.
Thanks for the ride, guys. Oh, that was excellent. That was really good. Shame we didn't see any tigers, but hopefully I will before I go. But anyway, I've got to go and see what Paul's been up to. Anyway.
Well, I've been looking for a place for us to stay tonight. Come on, take a look, yeah?
Please don't do that again.
Sorry.
Paul, I can't believe the only accommodation you could find for us was a bus. I mean, I know that house was bad, but I mean, a bus? Shut up, Paul.
So where are we going today, Rach?
It's about 100 miles north from the Eucerisk Reserve, and we're going to a tiger enclosure. It's one of the few places in the world where you might get the chance to see a Siberian tiger. So,
oh, brilliant.
Yeah, so fingers crossed we'll get to see it. Well, we've just arrived at the enclosure. It's absolutely huge here, and this is the watchtower, which I'm on now. And apparently there are 5 tigers here, so this is where I'm going to get the chance to see them in all their glory. These tigers are so rare and so endangered, and for me to be able to get a glimpse of them is a great privilege. If you can see, the tiger behind this tree here is probably very hot, and it's having a bath at the moment in this like green algae stuff. They must get so hot. It's just amazing to think that their temperatures change so dramatically. In the winter it's minus 40, in the summer it's like 90 degrees.
I prefer to be here now, to be honest, but I wonder what they prefer. Not one Siberian tiger, but five. And it's just unbelievable getting the chance to see them. They're absolutely beautiful animals. There's the mum, dad, and three little babies here. Well, they're not little, they're absolutely huge. And they're just so tame. They look so tame. They don't look fierce at all. They look really friendly, actually. I think they're probably very hot and very tired and just having a little sleep, a little rest. They have quite a large area where they roam, and they're really safe and they're really well looked after here, which is really nice to see. There are very few places where you can find the Siberian tiger. In China, there are less than 20. In North Korea, there's about 10. And there are 450 in Russia. So these tigers are very, very endangered. We need feeding time. They're beautiful animals, they are unbelievable. Didn't think I'd get to see them this close. He stares at you.
So, Rach, you're pretty glad that you got to see it?
Yes, I'm extremely glad I got to see it, yeah. I didn't think we'd get to see him this close and this many of them.
No, neither did I. No.
It's unbelievable. I never had a dream.
So, what's your highlight of the trip then?
Well, the biggest was finally getting to see the tigers after our long journey here and everything. Just getting to see them, and that was amazing. Dancing with the Russians.
Yeah, that was pretty mad. Yeah, it was a bit of a highlight for me, I think.
That was really good.
Yeah.
Meeting the anti-poacher brigade and doing all that kind of stuff for them, all like in the tank and
with
that.
The skins and
skins, that was really interesting. What about you?
Milking the goat was pretty mad for me, actually. Yeah, I've never done anything like that before. So, like, squishy, squishy. Yeah. It's been a mad trip, hasn't it?
It has. It's been a bit of an adventure.
Yeah, definitely an adventure.
Yeah, it's very different.
I think we should go, though.
I think it's time to go home now, yeah.
Okay. That's me, Dania. I'm